Triple J and Sting fighting up the stairs for a second, giving you the impression that they might be going to the top to jump down. Okay. And just as soon as you get that impression, it turns around, and of course, you know, Sting grabs his bat, and he, you know, and he pins.
Does his thing.
He pins Double J. So this was like matches, falls count anywhere, promos count anywhere. Great promo by 3D and Jesse Neal. Watch TNA.
My sixth segment, as you see, there's a whole page. It's a freaking promo, but I'm just gonna sum it up real simply. This is what Teddy Long, first of all, congratulates Big Show. Big Show at first did a great job. He's like, no selling. I'm like, hey man, Big Show, what do you need? Just didn't say a word. Didn't shake his hand. Then at the end goes, love you, man. And just walks away. Now here's where it all kind of goes to hell here. This promo went long. This is what Sheamus, Randy Orton, John Cena, freaking everybody came out here just basically to set up the main event for later tonight, which is a triple threat with Orton, Sheamus, and Batista to go on from there. But there was a couple lines here that was funny. I like it when, love it when Sheamus goes, sorry, fella, I don't deal with losers. That was funny. And then Cena had a funny line as well. Called Sheamus a jar of mayonnaise with eyeballs and a ketchup bottle hairdo.
He must be hungry.
And that's it. It was decent. It was just kind of long. But, you know, they had to get some mic time somewhere. There was eight matches on this card.
Well, where you were watching that, I had a one-eyed pope.
All right.
Pimp. Well, a one-eyed pimp. Anyway, he has a TNA little pimp belt. It's an actual belt. I really like it. He cuts a phenomenal promo. And then an interference by Kennedy. Yes, Kennedy, show the clip. He called him Kennedy. I couldn't believe it. We go to commercial.
Alright.
Kennedy.
Alright, my next segment 7, is the fourth match, the 10-woman battle royal. This is, 10-man battle royal, excuse me, why did I say that? This is SmackDown.
Maybe it was a bad match.
It was alright, went for 8 to 10 minutes. You had, you know, it was in it, Kane, Mysterio, Chad, Drew, McIntyre, R-Truth, MVP, Mark Henry, Yoshi Tatsu made an appearance, Santino as well, and Debussy.
Tater Tatsu.
3 draft picks went to the winner, and I'm going to take 7 and 8 all together here. Raw won this match. They ended up getting Morrison, R-Truth, and Edge.
Wow.
It was a decent match.
That has to be the turn.
The ending came out of DiBiase and Mysterio, and the best part was DiBiase beat him by getting a 2 Hurricanranas, stayed inside the ring. He held on the outside of the ring, but his feet didn't touch the ground.
Wow.
Mysterio went to charge at him, and he moves out the way, hits the ring post, boom. Mysterio's gone, and he won the match. Mysterio jobbed twice in 48 hours. That's pretty much it. It was decent.
X-Pac laid out by 3D, and I mean laid out, okay? And then Matt Morgan and Neil versus 3D. What match? Interference, the band, 12-second match. We got to play.
All right. My next segment is Jericho's promo. I love the talking about it, but simply put like this. Every single week, he does the best job in the world as
Jericho.
Yeah, as the cowardly heel. Nobody, I don't think, in wrestling history has done the cowardly, dastardly heel, the cunning heel, as good as Jericho. Edge is close, but just not as good. He can lose matches and never lose his heel.
Cowardly and cunning.
Yeah.
Did you Google the letter C today?
No. He basically calls out Heath Slater, demands an apology because Heath Slater, the rookie, beat him on NXT.
Okay.
And then we get the start of the 5th match right away. Jack Pick on the line. Jericho versus Christian in a 10-minute match.
Wow.
This match was awesome. Christian had a beautiful, well-timed hesitation drop kick to send Jericho outside of the ring. Then we go to a commercial.
Wow. Morgan forced to fight by Hogan. Either deal with Hogan or deal with Jesse Neal. I picked Jesse Neal too. Interference, by Shannon Moore, and it looks like they're about to make out. Eazy-E ranking system, supposed to be revolutionary. Turns out it's just an online voting thing. Interference by Black Machismo. Talking about Andre the Giant, yeah. We talked about that one. We got a question.
Wow, this is going to be a 3-part show.
Yes, it is.
All right, so the next match here I got. It's
5 hours of wrestling.
It is. I'm looking at the time here, and I'm going fast, and I can't.
Yep. Keep going.
You know,
keep
shit.
Keep going.
All right. The match continued between Jericho and Christian. It was another good match. 4 out of 5 matches so far have been good. Jericho wins the match by reversing the top rope move by Christian to the code breaker. Now, last night he did a springboard code breaker on Edge while Edge was on the middle rope. Jumped from one to the other, he does a springboard missile dropkick.
He did the code breaker
the same way last night. And Kofi is now going to SmackDown. Just as that. And it's a 10-minute match. Jericho wins, gets his heat back, and Kofi did hit him with the Trouble in Paradise. But
yeah, I like all these terms, man. Whatever. Yeah. Wrestling is real. People are fake.
Plus, you got it. I think we got
a new talk show coming up next week on TNA. It's called The Ozone with your favorite Orlando Jordan. So that's gonna be fun. That was a really good promo by him too.
Cool. The next match I have is the sixth match of the night. This is the rubber match, rematch of last week's SmackDown. This is World Champion Swagger versus John Morrison. Another good match, 14 and a half minutes. We had a unique modified enziguri by Morrison.
Good.
And then he did a corkscrew pescado. What's the commercial? But
I'm look at you.
But I'm jumping ahead here. I know. It's a
pescado.
Yeah. The match continues with another innovative abdominal stretch by Swagger using the ring ropes as leverage.
Cool.
We see the standing shooting star press. Swagger wins with the doctor bomb. Now, after Morrison was going for the Starship Pain, after he had control of the match. Again, a well-booked match. Swagger gets a win, finally another one in a row, gets some momentum going, and Christian now is going to SmackDown. I like this. He gets him off Raw because they weren't using him properly. You're up.
Flair loses the ring in fashion. This match was really fun. It had a restart, it had interference, it had all sorts of stuff. I don't want to give away too much, but I really enjoyed the match. Make sure you watch TNA.
Definitely watch TNA. The thing is, most people don't know is he doesn't watch WWE, and I don't watch TNA on the same night. We watch them on different nights.
I don't watch it at all.
He doesn't watch it at all. He has no idea what's going on. I don't know what he's talking about until I actually watch the freaking show.
And then you get upset.
Pretty much. I'm like, it's not as good as you said it was, but...
Well, this one is.
No, next week you're going to beat me. You know why? I have Lane Brady as my guest host next week.
Lane Brady.
Oh, jeez. Are you done? You got the main event, right?
No, I'm done.
Don't you have the main event, the O show? And then
the ring thing did. That was it.
Oh, and Hogan and freaking
slightly entertaining.
Right, well,
double rings at the end, you know, both rings spiked.
Alright, now we go backstage with DiBiase and Carlito and R-Truth. Basically, DiBiase's looking for the newest Virgil. That's right. Asking calling people out to be his lackey. It was pretty funny. R-Truth almost bought it, but then a bitch slapped him. Again, logic. There's a lot of logic on tonight's show. I love it. If you keep logic going, I'll be interested and I'll be excited like this because this is a great show. Now, my next segment, Dolph Ziggler had the seventh match of the night. This is sucked. Lost one swap in 40 seconds. Hey, it can't be perfect. Out of count.
Cheers, WWE.
This is what, you know how I lost? I've been throwing shit at you. Throwing like DX gear, like fucking gloves.
Can we move on? Because this is...
Yeah, it's horrible. Alright, next I got up here is, it goes right in, Raw gets Chris Jericho as a result of this match.
Oh,
and now
that's
I go,
pretty important.
Yeah, and now we go right into the, which Jericho on Raw and Edge. I mean, hell,
it seems
just
to me like they're switching networks.
Yeah.
And yet they're not bringing everybody to, they're bringing everybody to Raw again.
You know what, this is a two-part show. You know why? Because I got the main event next. I got 1 minute, I can cover this up quickly.
What are you talking about? We got intros and clips.
Ah, we're good. Check this out. This is Swagger, Orton, and Batista for the number one contendership. All I said before, I said it earlier, this is Batista's last hoorah. He wins. It was 17 minutes of good action. Edge ends up basically spearing Orton, starts the new feud, because now Orton and Edge are now on Raw. 8 matches total, phenomenal show, 70 minutes of wrestling. It was good. I mean, if we scored it, we would have killed you.
I agree. I think TNA did a great show, but it's hard to top something like...
A 3-hour Raw.
Good, right?
A 3-hour Raw. I mean, yeah, we have something.
Maybe it's time for a 3-and-A TNA. Get it? 3-and-A TNA. All right, that'll do it for us here at the Adult Demographic. Keep watching, bitches!